Welcome to a lesson on determining the distance between two parallel lines on the coordinate plane. The shortest distance between two parallel lines is the length of a perpendicular segment, as we see here in red. If the segment isn't perpendicular to both parallel lines, then it would not be the shortest distance. And notice how there are several options for a perpendicular segment. In fact, there's an infinite number of perpendicular segments between two parallel lines, but we want to determine a perpendicular segment where both endpoints would have integer coordinates. And we also need to remember that these red perpendicular segments would be on perpendicular lines. And remember, the slopes of perpendicular lines are negative reciprocals of one another. And just to review that, if we had two perpendicular lines, let's say the first line had slope negative 2/3, the second line is perpendicular to this, the slope would have to be the negative reciprocal of negative 2/3. Which means we'll flip it over and change the sign. So the slope of the second line would be positive 3/2. Looking at another example, if line 3 and 4 are perpendicular and line 3 had a slope of 5, it's going to be helpful to make 5 into a fraction, so we'll put 5 over 1, and if line 4 is perpendicular to this line, the negative reciprocal of 5 over 1 would be negative 1 over 5. Now, the only exception to this rule is if we have horizontal and vertical lines. A horizontal line has a slope of 0, and a vertical line has an undefined slope. And of course, horizontal and vertical lines are always perpendicular. Let's go ahead and take a look at our example. Here we want to determine the shortest distance between these two parallel lines. So step one, we need to find a convenient point on either line. So for example, this point here is convenient because the coordinates are 2, negative 3. Our next step is going to be to determine the slope of these blue lines. Again, there's a couple of ways of doing this. We could use the formula m equals y2 minus y1 over x2 minus x1, or we could, again, just pick two convenient points on either line and draw a triangle to determine the change in y with respect to the change of x, or rise over run. So if I selected this point here, and let's say this point here, I could go ahead and sketch a triangle which would show the rise over the run, or the change in y over the change of x. So notice that I would go up 2 units, that would be 2 for the change of y, then I go to the right 4 units, so the change of x is positive 4. So the slope of this blue line would be 2 over 4, or 1/2. The reason this is so helpful is, remember that the shortest distance between these two parallel lines would be a perpendicular segment. So the segment would have a slope that would be the negative reciprocal of 1/2. So that would be negative 2 over 1, or negative 2. But negative 2 over 1 is going to be actually more helpful. So what we'll do now is sketch a line with a slope of negative 2 that passes through this red point. And then from that line, we'll determine the endpoints of the perpendicular segment. So using the slope negative 2 over 1 from this point, we'll go down 2 and right 1. Now remember, it doesn't matter whether this negative is in the numerator or denominator. This is the same as 2 over negative 1. And the reason I mention this is I could go up 2 units and left 1 unit instead of going down 2 and right 1. Let's do that again. Let's go up 2 and left 1. And notice that we just found the point of intersection, which would be the end point of the perpendicular bisector. But let's go ahead and sketch the line anyway. So here's our perpendicular segment. And now we can see that the other end point is going to have the coordinates 0, 1. So we want to determine the distance between 0, 1 and 2, negative 3. So again, we'll call these the 1s. These the 2s, and now we'll use the distance formula to determine the distance between the two parallel lines. So we're going to have the square root of 2 minus 0 squared plus negative 3 minus 1 squared . So we'll have 2 squared, that's 4, plus this is going to be negative 4 squared, that's 16. Distance is equal to the square root of 20. Remember, the square root of 20 can be simplified. 20 is 2 times 2 times 5. So we have a perfect square factor here. So the distance is equal to 2 square root 5, which would be approximately 4.472. Now, I do want to mention this point of intersection right here was very convenient because the coordinates were integers. If it wasn't that easy to determine, we'd have to find the equation of this red line and then determine the equation of this blue line here and then solve it as a system of equations to determine this point of intersection. I hope you found this helpful. Thank you for watching.